let's first talk about raising a no bid contract limit from $10,000 to $25,000. What kind of harm does that do?
Well, it does a lot of harm. This is a series of bills that I believe fell under the radar. A lot of the groups didn't even realize that this was coming up. But what it basically does is it allows municipalities, school boards, authorities, the county, to basically call up three different companies and get a bid from them over the phone. It is not transparent. It doesn't allow smaller businesses to bid because they're not aware that there is any bidding
going
on.
There's a job out there.
Mm-hmm. There's a job out there. It hurts the minority businesses. It hurts women in business. It hurts everybody, basically, unless you're in power.
You're saying you're talking to one of your other colleagues in the House who worked with a company who saw bids coming in. A lot of bids out there for jobs fall under that $25,000 limit, that $25,000 price tag. So is this really, you said, trying to decrease competition out there?
I believe it's decreasing competition because I'm able to just call any three people, and basically there's no jurisdiction whether they tell each other what the prices are, and I'm not saying it just does not promote competitive pricing. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. If it's open to bidding, you'll get lower bids, and also I'm concerned about the quality of work.
Mm-hmm. And as you mentioned too, that as far as competition goes, very well, you could just say have three bids that come in and just give a job, say, to one of your friends. I mean, it's really bad for business, it's bad for good government, and like you said, doesn't provide any transparency when you're trying to really limit the number of bids that come in.
Right.
Mm-hmm. So ultimately, what happened to the bill then on the House floor?
The bill was passed, and I believe there was about 10 bills, and they all passed.
Mm-hmm. So really, what would you like to see in turn happen?
Well, I'd like to see at least municipalities take it upon themselves and jurisdictions to at least post it on their website. Allow people to bid on this. They just want a seat at the table. Just let them bid. Mm-hmm. And it's simple. So right now, local governments have that ability to pass that ordinance that they at least will post it or put it on their cable TV. That costs nothing.
Okay. So even though the bill now goes over to the Senate, it passed the House, I'm sure this won't be the last time we hear of you on this issue as it moves forward, and you continue to call attention to it as well.
Thank you.
Representative Davis, thanks for joining us.
Thank you.